Where the Crawdads Sing is a perfect example of passionate, like-minded people coming together. And we just mostly happen to be women. For all of us, the experience was extraordinarily special. We knew that we were working with something that was a jewel. We revered Delia's work. We revered Delia.
Elizabeth Gabler is a longtime collaborator and mentor and friend of mine. She is meticulous with making sure adaptations are accurate, that really reflect the same feelings that you get when you read the book. You're gonna have them when you go see the movie.
The book itself is about having the strength to keep going. But I chose a female character because I do think it's important in today's world to empower women. And the fact that we had so many female actors and director, screenwriter, the producers, all of these women came together. And I think that a lot of viewers are going to feel the strength behind that.
For me, it was so inspiring to see because it's not often you see a majority female crew in lead sort of positions. And so I think it's also really helpful in terms of this character's journey because Kaya is a character that's underestimated. And I think for years, you know, women have been. So I think it's really exciting to be telling stories that celebrate strong, powerful, complicated women.
Truly the heartbeat of this movie is Libby Newman. She presented images that were so detailed, that were so thoughtful, but also really channeled this character and this person in this world.
I think Kaya is a really honest female character. You know, she's honest in her desires for human connection. She's honest in her shyness, and she also struggles with her own self-worth and then finds it. And what we found in casting Daisy was an actress who could really inhabit all of that.
Olivia Newman is the perfect director to bring Crawdads to life because she loves working with actors, and our characters and their performances are the most important thing. She also has a very strong maternal instinct, being the mother of two young children, and we have young actors playing the younger counterparts. Livy's sensibility has been tremendously encouraging and empathetic and compassionate for these younger people, and it's really proving to give us those strong, emotional, and really powerful performances that we need.
Whenever I'm putting together a film and hiring department heads, I'm always looking to connect with other creatives who bring the same passion and the same vision. And in this case, the people happen to be women. And I don't think that's a coincidence because of this character that we all really connect to and root for.
We just connected immediately about how we felt this story should be told. I almost get goosebumps sometimes when we're framing up a shot and it's something that we've talked about, like the feather tree stump, which was our day one of photography, was such a phenomenal tree. And I don't think that I'll ever have a day one of photography like that.
It is a rare occasion to be surrounded by a sisterhood when making a film. Having a woman behind the camera, it is a beautiful thing. I mean no disrespect to any man, but a story like this belongs in the hands of women.
Sue Chan's incredible production design, every detail, she imagined it in her mind and she brought it to life.
We had lots of discussions about how we were going to achieve the progression of the artwork and the progression of her home from the time she's a little girl to when she is left by her family to when she comes into her own, how we would create that visually.
It's really fun to work with Sue on these sets. There's a conscious decision behind every element, every paint color, every window finish. Probably a viewer will never notice, but nothing was chosen without thought to why that character would have picked that.
I've never worked with so many women before. It's incredible. Each and every one has such a strong vision.
Mirren's costumes are incredible. The thought that she put into every single pattern, fabrics, color stories, there's been so much attention to detail.
I think we've really bonded on trying to make Kaya this unique individual who loves color and nature and all these things that surround her and how to incorporate those pieces of nature into her wardrobe.
I hope being a part of such a women-led team becomes less and less of something interesting as the years go on. I hope to see a lot more inclusion and diversity in film crews, on the creative team, in production, because I think that's how you hear about who we are as human beings.
I love the idea of female partnership. It has powered so much in my life. Working on a production like Where the Crawdads Sing, there's just incredible, powerful fuel in those partnerships. You know, we feed each other creatively, we encourage each other, and it's just been a life-changing experience for me.